As St. Lucia partially reopens its borders, fears of a second wave hitting the island have been expressed. Government is fully aware of this possibility and is taking the steps to engage stakeholders in discussion on the way forward. Commerce Minister Bradley Felix says it's a delicate situation in which government must weigh the benefits and disadvantages.
Any additional cases that come, you know, with a bang will cause significant concerns, and as a country we think it would be you know, extremely delicate to close down the economy again. So we have to take every precaution to ensure that you know, we're on top of that one.
Liquor establishments, which were shut down when the government instituted a state of emergency, are breathing a sigh of relief now that the ban on the sale of liquor has been lifted. Business owners and the government have lost millions of dollars as a result of the pandemic.
I don't know from the Department of Commerce, but the, I mean, feedback generally from the business owners, they welcome it. You know, it appears that quite a few people, you know,
were quite impatient on the length of time it took, but everything happens in its own time. So I think there's some satisfaction that it's finally open, and we're hoping for the best going forward.
Whatever happens within the immediate future, Prime Minister Alan Chesney has already asserted that there will be no complete shutdown like what happened on March 31st. The worst case scenario, he says, would be the closure of the island's borders. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.